Sassy Mama and Sassy Sasu bringing you Pani Puri. We are going to have Puchka party. How I met my mother-in-law. I remember walking into Akshay's house, seeing this lady with her tattoos and her heavy metal music. She was wearing boots and she gave me Pani Puri.
So, for dinner.
For dinner, yes. That's a very Guju thing. And I cannot tell you how I fell in love with it. So today we decided to talk about how I met the mother-in-law. Let's get cracking with Pani Puri.
Okay, we're starting with boiled potatoes, boiled chana, boiled moong, some fudina, onion, limbu, adrak, some coriander. This is how I put it into the mixer. I always remove my greens from water so the mud remains down. And into this, I'm going to add some salt, chilies as per your taste. This is my taste. And water. You can add some water into this, no issues, because it's going to end up into water also. This is how the beautiful green chutney looks like. And to taste, oh my God. Hot as hell. So I take some of the mixture and put it into water. Into that, a spoonful of jeera, spoonful of dhania, and a good amount of rock salt. I don't use the ready-made market masala. Give it a wonderful stir and I leave this for 3 hours at least.
For the date and tamarind meetha chutney, all you need is tamarind and dates boiled together, and then after 20 minutes, after cooling it down, you put it through a sieve and you get this beautiful yummy chutney, to which you add a spoon of jeera powder, red chili powder, salt, and of course jaggery. That's your super duper easy meetha chutney, guys. Sassy Sasu is an awesome mix between traditional and very cool.
What is this very, very nice introduction? I'm liking. We had a person who used to cook in a house called Durga. And Durga is the one who's taught me this pani. And it's amazing. I've been using this for the last 40 years. You have the boiled moong, the boiled chana, the boiled potato. You can put chaat masala in all three of these. It helps. Extra chutney. And there is dahi, which has been beaten with the puris. So what happens is, suppose your children don't enjoy this and eat just the meetha chutney, you put dahi into it. Now, somebody here is not a very spicy person, right?
It's not that I don't like spicy, I'm just very sweet. Basically, she is a spicy one and I'm the sweet one.
65 and spicy. Of course, tikhi. All women my age gotta do this, baby. How is it?
You know, she gets it right each time. And that's why I can never eat pani puri outside. It's reminding me of the first time we met.
Thank you, Durga. I will always remember this.
Keep cooking for me, okay?
Yeah.
Now, the traditional pani puri, yes, does come with ragda and bundi, and there are many different versions. But we make the healthier version, which is using brown chana. That's because we are healthy people in this house. Add chaat masala on this, which I don't have right now, sorry. And I'm gonna feed my mom-in-law.
Oh my! Mmm. Mmm.
It's good, right? The way I am behaving like I made this pani puri and all I did was make the meetha chutney. But I will tell you that the hard part is the pani with the balance of flavors that she gets right all the time. But please try pani puri at home. It is not that hard and it is awesome. I have to adjust height here.
Of course.
So I have to go down.
Of course.
Like down. Now we try to get each other in a frame. I hope you liked the pani puri of today.
Spicy as hell.
And sweet like May. But listen, the whole point of this and our videos is to get all you ladies rocking with your mother-in-laws, okay? Yes. So please comment in the comment section and tell us who is spicier. Mama-in-law Sasuma or daughter-in-law. Alright, girls and guys, see you soon. Bye.